guys, it's Amy from Radiantly Amy, and I've got another perfume review. Now, I have an embarrassing confession to make. You guys had asked me to do a review of Prada Candy, and I thought I had it, because I knew I had a Prada Candy perfume. However, because I see Prada, whoops, how do I do it? Prada, it's not focusing, but okay. And then this side says candy. So I thought I had Prada Candy. Long story short, as I'm looking at this, as I'm kind of looking it up to get the notes and stuff, I'm like, wait a minute, this bottle looks totally different. This is Prada Candy Gloss, which is a completely different perfume. Whoa. So I will be doing a review of Prada Candy Gloss instead of Prada Candy, because I apparently don't have Prada Candy handy. And now I do think I have a perfume sample somewhere, so I might be able to dig that up and do that at some point. But for our review today, it's gonna be Prada Candy Gloss, which is actually, this was a happy accident, because I ended up really liking this one. I sprayed this a little while ago because I like to get it on and see like how it sits and things. But I'll give it another spray. As you can see, this one is like a pink bottle and it's pink all over. The Prada Candy one has more of a fuchsia color. It's clear, so you can see like the actual stuff, which would have been tip off number one. But here we go. I'm gonna give it a spritz. Eee. That wasn't a really good spray. Oh, I did it again. That was really liquidy. It's like running down my arm. So the first, I always like give it a second to like chill, because when you first spray it, it's always kind of that alcohol woof. Now this perfume, as I spray it, I'm getting like a cherry. It's definitely got a cherry note, and I think that's what makes it a little different than the other Prada Candy one. I looked at the notes of Prada Candy when I thought I had Prada Candy. These notes are different. Wow, Amy. So like, whereas the regular Prada Candy has, let me look up their notes, is more of a caramel as a main note, and like there's a little bit of vanilla. This one is different. It's got cherry and almond as a note, vanilla. I'm seeing cherry, almond, vanilla. They've got some peach. Kind of, is that mint? No, cassis, orange blossom, rose. Oh, I don't, yeah, maybe a little, I get a rose smell. But when you first smell it, it's cherry almond. And now that I'm smelling it, I don't want to say it smells like that Jergens cherry almond, like lotion that everybody, you probably know when you think of Jergens, maybe not, because Jergens is kind of old school. But it's got a little bit of that tone or that vibe to it. It's sweet, but it's not, I'm getting that clean. And you know, now that I'm smelling it, that clean smell is the Jergens like cherry almond scent. It's that combination. Now I'm like, aha, because I was getting kind of a clean whiff. And it's, you know, I tend to like perfumes that are either sweet, like Choco Musk and Hypnotic Poison, that have kind of that vanilla scent or like a caramel scent, things like that. Or I like clean, like the clean perfumes that smell like a, you know, you're just out of the shower. And it's hard to find one that kind of combines those two things, because they're kind of weird notes to combine. But Choco Musk does it really well. It's both like a sweet chocolate scent and kind of fresh. And this has actually got a touch of that. And I think it is the cherry almond smell. It's interesting. I thought I was gonna hate this actually, because it's been sitting. I bought it and then didn't wear it. Like, I probably wore it like the first week or the first month, and then I kind of set it aside and I haven't come back to it. So much so that I forgot that it wasn't Prada Candy. So now I would actually come back to this a little bit. It's an interesting scent. There is a little touch of like a lemony smell, which I don't even see as a note in here, and I don't know what's causing that. There is a peach note, but yeah, I'm not sure what that is. I'm getting like a zing. That Jessica Simpson's, her perfume has it too, Fancy, has this weird little note that always kind of grates at me. And this has a lesser version of that. I actually liked Fancy and I wore it for a long time, but I smelled it on someone else and it turned me off completely from the perfume. It was weird. But it's that note and I don't know what it is, but this has just a hint of it. It's not like strong like it is in Fancy to where you can't kind of ignore it. This one, it's under there. I can smell it and whatever it is, it's something that I personally think I have like an aversion to. I don't think anybody else like kind of like goes ugh, like I do. But it's not strong enough to like be a problem in this one. And even on Fancy, I wore that for a long time. So yeah, as I'm smelling this, it's almost like a sweet tart scent. You got a little bit of that powdery, sweet powder is kind of what I smell when I'm kind of just like here. When I go a little closer is when I get the really strong cherry almonds, and I like cherry perfumes. There's not a lot that do it well. I can't really even think of one cherry perfume that I kind of dig because I've had a hard time finding one that I like. I tried Cherries in the Air and that one was too like strong and wow. Like I think that was by Escada. It was too much and it gave me a headache. But this has got just a touch of the cherry and I think mixing it with the almond smell helps. Kind of toned down because you know sometimes berry smells can go either way, but I'm actually enjoying this, and there is a little bit of the peach, and it could be the peach that's kind of standing out to me. But yeah, as I smell, it's not a bad smell. It's pleasant. It's not overly strong. I'm seeing the reviews on it say it's got moderate longevity. Sillage is moderate as well from what people are saying. So that's like how close you have to be to smell it, you know, and how does it waft kind of. Like this one, I smell it and I have a bad nose right now, you know, I've got this cold that I'm getting over with, but I can smell it like from here. It's definitely, you don't have to be right up on it. Now when I do get right up on it is when I smell the cherry stands out a lot to me. When I'm a little further away, it's just kind of like a sweet powdery scent. So it's not bad. I mean, I kind of like it. It's weird. It's not, I don't think this would become like my new, you know, holy grail scent. I tend to prefer ones that are a little, not this, but this isn't bad. And it's, I would wear this again. I might even wear it, you know, to work tomorrow and see kind of how it goes and how long it lasts on me and things like that. Sometimes they change a lot. This one seems to be kind of staying about the same as I smell it. I think what kind of made me put this one aside is just, it's kind of, this is it. Like, it's not bad. It's not overly like, yay. It's just there. It smells good and it's nice. And I don't think it's super, like, I don't think people would find this super offensive. It's not choking me. And I'm right up on it. So it's nice. It's just nice. And I don't think that's, like, a bad review or a good review. It's pleasant. If you like kind of candy smells, if you like sweet smells. And definitely if you like cherry, because it is hard to find a nice cherry. It's there. The cherry's blending, I think, a little bit with the almond smell and the powdery smell to be kind of not, it's not, like, I wouldn't necessarily have thought this was cherry when I smelled it, but now that I'm seeing cherry and almond as the notes, I can definitely, the Jergens vibe has gone down a lot now that I've let it sit a little bit, and it's just kind of like a sweet powdery scent, and, you know, I think that's kind of what has made this like an okay perfume for me. It's just sweet powder. And there's a lot of perfumes that kind of end up being sweet powdery smells. So it's not bad. It's not like my favorite, but I don't hate it. And I would say go give this a sniff and maybe go to Ulta or Sephora somewhere and give it a spray. See how you think. It's really not bad at all. I'm still sniffing as I huff my arm. But yeah, it's sweet and powdery. So there you go. That is Prada Candy gloss and not Prada Candy. Sorry about that, guys. I will do, I'm sure I have a Prada Candy somewhere around my house as a sample or something that I can do at some point. But yeah, for now, this is the review you get of Prada Candy gloss.